A long time ago in Raven's village, there were no salmon. Raven would try to make some by carving them out of wood and then throw them into the water. They would jump a few times, then die. Discouraged by his attempts, he decided to travel across the ocean to visit the salmon people. Raven asked his friend Mouse if he would like to go along. Together they traveled by canoe until they reached the village of the salmon people, where the land was flat. On the beach in front of the village, there were many canoes made from the skins of sockeye salmon. Seeing the guests, the chief invited them to his house. Raven had a plan. He asked Mouse to stay behind and chew holes in all of the canoes on the beach. At the chief's house, everyone sat down to dinner. Raven was served a beautiful sockeye salmon, which was actually the chief's daughter. Raven carefully examined the fish to see if he could find what was missing in his salmon. The chief stood and ordered that no one was to eat the bones, but Raven kept one and hid it in the roof of his mouth. When everyone had finished, the chief asked that a basket be gathered for Raven's journey home. He then ordered that all of the salmon bones be gathered and taken to the river to be thrown in. To Raven's amazement, they immediately turned into a salmon that began swimming back to shore, then started swimming in circles and jumping madly. Everyone knew what was wrong. A bone was missing. They searched the house and found nothing. They called to Raven and asked, "May we check your mouth?" There they found the bone. But Raven just said that he did not know that the bone was there. He began to make another plan. He asked the chief to allow his daughter to deliver the basket of food to Raven's canoe. When Raven stepped into his canoe, he pushed it out into the river just as the chief's daughter approached the canoe. When she waded out into the river up to her waist, Raven grabbed her and started racing down the river. All of the salmon people got into their canoes to give chase, but they all sank, for Mouse had chewed the holes in all of them. Raven returned to his village and released the chief's daughter into the waters. Ever since, sockeye salmon have returned to Raven's village, where the people are very strict in returning bones back to the river after eating salmon.